Yes,
This
hashtag.
is hashtag sexy Bobbelly. Yeah, this is our second episode. And we're going to be doing Final Space.
For those
And
of you who haven't seen it, it's an
maybe
absolutely great show.
it's an amazing show and we're going to be talking about it soon. And maybe if Mr. Good Luck Louie were here, old Lou Meister, Luminator, if he has any time to do another back-to-back off what was the one we were talking about, Darcy?
Back to back. Oh, we're gonna do Titans on the next one.
Titans. So we might do Titans. We don't know. This could be like part one and two where we do Final Space and then Titans, but it's like the same episode. But yeah, okay, so Darcy, St. Louis. What do you think about Final Space? Give it a go.
My thoughts on this series are that it's an absolute hit. I feel like Netflix is very wishy-washy with a lot of their content, especially when it comes to animation. I've noticed that they've been trying to put out a lot of content, which hasn't really been sticking for me personally, but I feel like Final
Okay.
Space kind of hits all the corners and checks all the boxes of things that I really like. It's got an A-list cast, it's
Right.
got great jokes, it's got characters that are easy to understand and easy to follow along with and easy to empathize with. So
Okay.
all around, I'd say it's a very satisfying show. I enjoyed the first season through and throughout. I've watched it maybe three times so far, just the first season itself, and I gotta say I'm very, very, very excited for season two.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited for season two as well. Now, if you guys don't know what Final Space is, Final Space is an animated series. It's a Netflix original, and they're episodes of this. I think we can give them the premise. So basically, you want to give them the premise, Darcy? I'm a little high right
Oh,
now. I told you I
absolutely.
just
So
came back
no,
from a dupe, right? So I'm sorry
no
about that.
problem, no problem.
Sorry about
So
that. All
deep.
right.
So Final Space follows the main character of Gary, who's trapped in a space prison, and he's finally run into some people who aren't his roommate Kevin, who's a anti insanity tool, and his house, which is known as Hugh, which is a playoff Hal from Space Odyssey 2001. So essentially what happens is he runs into Mooncake, which is a little alien with the ability to destroy planets. They get
Or
hunted by bounty hunters,
he's called the
and
planet killer, right? Mooncake's called
the
the planet
planet
killer.
killer.
That's right.
He has
He's this.
a name which is like A372 or some sort of number, but I
Yeah,
can't
it's
remember
this number
off
by the Lord Commander.
the top.
He's
But along with a
a
lot of
pretty
other
interesting character.
absolutely with time travel and a couple other sci-fi tropes that I find very interesting, they've been able to make this full picture of a series which includes hyperspeed, time folding,
Yeah.
extraterrestrials, and just
Great.
everything you'd want to see out of a sci-fi series.
Great. Yeah, I like the animation. I think the animation's cool. I want to break down like the characters. What do you think of Gary? Because I think he's hilarious. He's over he's an over the top character. He's he's funny. He has his moments. He knows like inside deep down, I think he knows he's like the best. He's like the best at, everything, and he encourages himself that he's like a positive character if you really look at it. Like, what do you
Oh,
think?
absolutely, absolutely. I feel like a lot of television shows, especially for their first series, usually try to play to like this everyman idea of a person. So when they develop a personality, they make them kind of very wishy-washy. But right off the bat, you kind of see what kind of character Gary is. He's
Yeah.
very outspoken. He's not direct kind of, like he's kind of weird. He's kind of kooky, which I feel
Yeah.
like even if you're not that type of guy, you know that type of guy. And and it kind of sets him aside from the other characters to let you know that he is his own person, with his tropes, his ability to crack jokes even in the most facetious situations. I believe, you know, as a character, Gary, he reminds me a little bit of Deadpool. He's kind of got like, he always gets the last word. He has something funny to say. And even when he gets his arm ripped off, he's got like 18 like references he's going to drop on.
Yeah, and I like how what's the AI's name? What's the name of the Hugh. AI? Hugh, right? I love how there's this relationship that they've built where it's very like, even though Hugh's like, you know, in charge and Gary's like the prisoner, it's, they have a relationship. They have this bond between them. Like even when you see that scene where Hugh says, right at the end, where he says something to Gary just before Gary loses air, you know, that the last episode, right?
Yep.
And he says something over there, which obviously I can't remember because I'm a little high right now. But if you watched it, you should watch it because it's amazing. It's they show how close an AI and a human can be. So they're kind of breaking that barrier.
Oh, absolutely.
In animation, you know, in a cartoon form, in a form where everybody can understand it. Like, even me.
So, Johan, I had a question for you.
Sure.
Favorite character and why?
This is a good question. Because initially, I liked Avocado, the assassin cat man, like Gary says, cat man. And but I think Mooncakes, not because he's the center of the whole problem at hand, but because he's an interesting character, because even though he doesn't speak, there's kind of conversation and everybody understands what he's trying to say, and he's like all about love and he doesn't understand his power, basically. Like, he doesn't understand how strong he is and how he can destroy planets with like one, you know, beam of light. And he's an interesting character. Obviously Gary, don't get me wrong, Kevin at number three. You have to love Kevin. You have to love him because he saved the fucking day. He saved the fucking day. You know it.
Yeah, Kevin. And then, voiced by Fred Armisen, by the way. Very hilarious.
Very hilarious. Hashtag follow Fred Armisen. He's fucking hilarious. Did I say his name right? Armisen? Yeah.
Armisen.
Anyway, Darcy, I don't want to break the flow of this conversation, but why don't you tell everybody where you're going tonight? Going to meet a lady tonight?
Well, if there's ladies there, I'd like to meet some of them. I mean,
you're looking all dapper, got a nice little haircut, and you know,
this is the
seeing you
this
in a
is
shirt,
one of the segments
time,
of the podcast.
The only
what
time
is going
seeing
on
you in
with
a shirt?
His love life?
The only time
I don't wear button-ups that often, but when I do, I like to leave an impression.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The only time I've seen you in a shirt is at my wedding, where, you know, you look dapper as fuck.
Well, you know, I just, no matter where I go, I gotta look better than someone.
Great. You look good, buddy. Look like a handsome
Well, thank
fuck.
You. I appreciate the compliments. You know what? I wasn't having such a good day, and you're picking me right up, so.
Always. That's what I do. That's what this cheese does. Picks up people and just, you know, makes them happy and then says, hey, why don't you follow my SoundCloud account?
All right, I'll make an account already.
helps a grandma cross the street, and then you're like, oh, by the way, you want to follow my SoundCloud account?
I'm on Instagram, like, by the
SoundCloud?
Way.
SoundCloud? So I pose the question to you. Who's your favorite character and why? Or you don't have to say why, but who's your favorite character?
Well, I'll give an answer to both those questions. First off, my favorite character is Tribor Menendez, which is Quinn's partner.
Tribor Menendez.
Why am I asking this question? Yeah, that guy is my favorite. Hands down my favorite. Every time he's on screen, I'm laughing. I'm laughing hard. He's always just saying the most ridiculous shit. So, you know what? There's no time he's been on screen where I haven't had a smile on my face and I'm not just kind of laughing and giggling at all the stuff he's saying. In this series, I have to go with, like, my favorite character being the guy who makes me laugh the most. This season, it's got to be Tribor Menendez. And Gary's got to be a close second, but Tribor
Gary's is always going to be a close second. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, he's hilarious.
He is hilarious.
Hilarious.
What do you think of the end? Let's remind me what happened there. Like, because
you watched the series, right?
I did. No, you have to remind me because one, I'm high, so you know.
All right. So at the end of the series.
And why don't we let our viewers know, too, you know?
Well, hashtag spoilers. Yeah, so at the end of the series, Avocado obviously dies. You're there with Little
Combo. That was like episode like halfway 7 or 8, right? Yeah, halfway into the show, yeah.
Yeah, and so what ends up happening is Gary ends up going back in time. And meeting his father, and then they have like a bonding experience, and they find out that the Lord Commander used to be partners with his father.
Yeah, no, but what happened at the end? What was the?
I'm getting there. Can a motherfucker finish?
I'm just trying to remember the end, because I remember all of that. I remember the part where they found out and they beat the Lord Commander together as father and son. Do you remember that? Right?
I remember.
I remember all of that. But I'm talking about, like, how did it end? Because I know there was a cliffhanger.
Gary sacrifices himself, and then there's a time loop.
Right. Okay. Do you think that was a good end to a season?
I really, like, on the initial first season, I get why they kind of play up somebody dying, especially the first character, because you don't know whether or not you will get a season 2. So you want to do something very conclusive with, at the same time, leaving space to do more in the future. You want to get both the best of both worlds, which I feel like they kind of did. And I don't feel like I could have done it any better. I feel like they kind of hit it on the head with what they were doing. I know that there is going to be a season 2. I have been looking it up. And you know what? I feel like the way they left it off will definitely be interesting to see how they do pick it up. So you know what? I'm very anxious to see what's going to happen, especially in season 2 when it comes out to Netflix.
Netflix has been doing a few animated shows recently. There's that one about the girl who becomes king or something like that.
Oh, the Simpsons show that's Disenchanted.
No, Disenchanted, yes. Is that a Simpsons show? Is that by Matt Groening?
Yes, sir.
Oh, shit. Okay. Very nice. I watched a couple of episodes of that, but didn't get too much into it. Again, it's like... I like that that show too, like Final Space, has a storyline and it's not a different episode it's not a different thing every episode. It's not a different story. They start with the end and it works its way from the start to the end again. It's pretty cool. It's well done. I like stories like that because it always grips you. It always catches you into the next episode, because you essentially want to know what happened. You know the person's gonna die. Like, there's a show my wife and I watch called How to Get Away with Murder. And yep. You watch that, right? So it's very similar.
Oh, no, I never watch that garbage.
The premise of the show is... the premise of the show
is... Is it How to Get Away with Murder?
Yeah.
Is that the premise of the show?
No.
I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. I'm sorry. I don't mean to do that. No. The premise of the show is... So they show you who gets murdered right at the beginning of the season. And then they work themselves up to how it happened and why and who murdered the person. And Final Space is something like in that realm where it starts at the end and it works itself like up to how, why, when, and how he got himself there finally, and you know what they do, which is pretty cool. I like the end. I think the end was pretty cool. Now that you reminded me.
I really liked it.
It was very similar to the Umbrella Academy, where they go back in time, where there's like, it has to do with like time travel. And so, yeah, that's my take on this.
Gonna give it a percentage, grading it a 0 to 100.
99.99.
All right. I mean, you don't really leave any breathing room. I mean, like, I guess in your eyes, there's not a show getting better than this one. But I'd say
I give a lot of shows 99.99, but Game of Thrones 100.
I'm gonna give it like a 78. I'm gonna give it like a 78.8. Based on my ability to do math and my ability to watch shows simultaneously.
I just want to know, let anybody know, whoever's watching and listening to this, that I forgot what I was going to say. That's what it is. I forgot what I was going to say right now. Immediately, while I was saying it, I forgot what I was going to say.
This has been the best podcast I've ever been part of.
I think. I love it.
I genuinely mean that. Oh, this is great.
You know what? So, Darcy and I are soon probably going to be going into a professional studio. Ooh. And recording this. And... yeah, maybe with a little better sound quality, a little better video quality. If we have video in it, we can do video. Just put my iPad out there. I use my iPad for everything. Everything.
Johan's the man.
All through school, when I did my 2 years of postgrad in Waterloo, I used my iPad for all my projects. All these nerds were using like their laptops with like keyboards. Fuck a keyboard. I don't need a keyboard.
I never went to college, like, so
doesn't
I
matter.
Trust you.
It doesn't matter. You should use an iPad. That's all that matters. iPad will give you everything. Just any smart device, really. Not the iPad specifically. I'm a little too attached to my iPad.
All right, so since we've kind of gone off the rails a little bit, I feel like now's a good time for me to do a little bit of an advertiser reading. So for those of you in the Halton or Peel region, Pineal Coffee. They didn't give me anything to read from, so I just kind of got to freestyle it. Yeah, Halton or Peel region coffee. They do Pineal Coffee. That's P-I-N-E-A-L coffee. Yeah. They have their website's coming soon. You can find them on social media. They do catering. They do events, big and small. They have coffee, iced coffee, apple fritters, waffles, and all of it's pretty delicious. The iced coffee has 30 grams of protein, And it's all really good stuff. If you're health conscious and you're a morning person, I mean, I couldn't imagine having a get together and not inviting the good people of Pine Hill Coffee to cater my get together.
What's your what's your email address, Darcy? How are they going to get in touch with you? What's your email address?
My email address. Well, you don't need my email address.
In touch, what if they want to get in touch with you to Pioneer, get your cure?
But
do you have a website?
Well, the catering business's website is it's Pineal Coffee, that's Pineal Coffee Coffee @gmail.com. They cater in the Peel region of Ontario and Halton region. Yes.
Great.
That's the only contact okay. We kind of have right
that's
now.
Perfect.
But you know
that's
what?
Perfect. Because what if somebody wants to get in touch with you? That's what I'm saying, right? Your yeah. email address would be the best way to. And I've said it once, and I'm going to say it again. Best coffee in the world. I drink it all the time. 10 cups a day.
Good on you.
Sometimes. Decaf one. They have great coffee. The best coffee in the world. Pineal Coffee. Drink it.
Primo.
All the time. Primo. Number one. Numero uno. One.
Juan Valdez.
Juan Valdez. Juan. So final thoughts on Final Space.
My verdict, I definitely got to come back for a season two. When season two pops up, I got to see it. I'm pretty happy with everybody. New characters I'd like to see. I don't know. I'd like to see Avocado come back eventually. I'd like to see, I want to see what's going on in the future timelines with future Quinn. And you know what? They left enough open that I'm definitely still guessing. So the verdict is I'm coming back.
I want to see a little backstory in the Lord Commander. I know we saw some where his origins, where he kind of got fucked up and shit, but I want to see how he built his army and got shit going and started trying to rule the planet and where he got all these powers, because they don't show that, do they?
He gets cosmically radiated.
Yeah, but do they show how he got his powers initially?
It was kind of alluded to that, like the cosmic radiation, but I don't know, nothing's really in stone unless it's said.
Right, so I want to see something like that. That'll be nice to see, because I like the bad guy too. Like, I like Darth Vader,
Lord Commander, voiced by David Tennant, by the way, the 10th Doctor, or the 9th Doctor, I can't remember.
The 9th Doctor? Okay, yeah, from Doctor Who. Okay, got it.
From Doctor Who Ain't.
Yeah, who ain't know about this. Do you know about this, Darcy? Do you know about this? Because that haircut is so fresh right now. That is the freshest haircut ever. Are you planning to get laid tonight? Because
I only get the dopest fades, Johan. I think my reputation should precede me by now. Dope fades.
Dope fades at Darcy's. Darcy's dope fades.
That's my barbershop.
Darcy's
dope fades.
I like it. I mean, a triple D, you know? No, but for real, who cut your hair?
Oh, some lady at Sports Clips. I don't know. I don't have a fixed barber. There's not someone I'm going back to. It's not like Dante on the block is cutting this shit. No, it's just some lady. All right, what are your final thoughts, Johan, before we wrap up?
Are we wrapping up? Okay, my final thoughts are, I love the show. Great animation, like I said before. I'm giving, like, generic answers today because I'm so high. But I like the storyline. I want them to continue with the storyline where it keeps us captivated and not lose interest in season two, because shows can do that to you sometimes, where they do really well in season one and then kind of drop off in season two, will get like really boring, like True Detective. So I don't want that to happen. I want the continuity of the high of watching this show, and I want it to get better. I hope they introduce some more characters because I think there's space for it. Final space for it, that is. And hashtag final space. And yeah, that's my final thoughts on it. And, you know, always, Darcy, remember this. Always drink Mountain Dew because shit's the best. Every day. My wife hates it. Armor. But I love Mountain Dew.
Dentists hate it. Johan loves it.
Love it.
All right. Do you got a sign off term you're gonna use yet?
What's your Instagram? Where do people follow you, Darcy?
Oh, you can follow me on Instagram at Good Luck Louie, at Good Luck Louie. That's G-O-O-D, Luck, L-O-U-I-E. Or you can follow me on Twitter at Darcy.irrelevant.
Okay. And ladies, I've said it once. I've said it before. The sexy single man here. Very clean. Disease-free Darcy Louis. Not Louis. Darcy Louis. St. Louis.
I have many. I go by many
He's
names.
He's disease-free. But that's all that
disease-free
matters.
Disease-free and many names.
Disease-free and his fade is unfucking real right now. So, yeah, it is unreal right now. So, follow Good Luck Louis. You sound like an old man, but you look young as fuck. Young AF.
Well, thank you.
And you can follow me. You can follow me at Discheese if you want to listen to techno music, because that's what I do. I make techno music. And Dr. Darcy about movies and TV shows and comedy. We're just talking. And this is what we're talking about. And viewers, you have a good weekend.
Like I said, stay classy, everyone.
Stay classy and disease free. Remember, put a jacket on it, because hashtag put a jacket on it. And Darcy, you have yourself a good Saturday night, because you know, you're getting wet tonight, so enjoy.
Likewise.
All right. Okay. I'm married right now, so, you know. It's like a one-off. I got a bet on
it. Oh, I know he likes to get wet.
I got a bet on it sometimes. Anyway, enough about me. I'm out. Sexy Paw Belly. Follow us on Instagram at Sexy Paw Belly. SexyPawBelly. Darcy, you have yourself a great night. And I will